welcome to Faith and Friends. We're excited to spend the next 30 minutes with you. It's the final full week of September, and we have some great things coming up in today's show.
Alongside Danny Lynch, I'm Mark Koontz. One of those things involves a battle of our own Jennifer and Zach. Obviously, they are not with us right now, and soon you'll know why. It's something called Battle Run.
I hope they both come back standing. We'll see. Also on today's show, remember the cow from the auction? Of course you do. Well, that little guy has
a new
home. Well,
actually, wouldn't it be a little girl? Because if it was a guy, it'd be a bull, not a cow.
That's a great point. It is a moofully sweet update. I don't know what that means.
Moofully? Maybe it's going to move you to, well, we'll tell you about that later on. A lot more to come on today's show. But first, our scripture of the day, which comes from 2 Chronicles 20, 14 through 15. Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehizel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jehiel, the son of Mattaniah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph, in the midst of the assembly. And he said, "Listen, all you of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and you, King Jehoshaphat, thus says the Lord to you, do not be afraid nor dismayed of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's."
Battle, that is a key word. The battle is not yours, it's God's. And coming up in just over a week, you have an opportunity to take part in the first of its kind, Battle Run. It's taking place in Shawnee at Heritage Park and is designed to raise money for missions, but also impact the lives of those involved in the Battle Run and impact those lives for Christ. That is where we find Zach and Jennifer. They're at Heritage Park with a little preview of this Battle Run.
Thanks, Mark and Andy. Well, are you ready for this?
I think I'm ready. I'm not entirely sure what I've gotten myself into yet. I do know it involves battling something. Am I going to war?
Well, I think we're all at war in some way, shape, or form.
Well, I don't know if that's what we're doing today.
Nope. There's a fly here. The fly is not a part of the battle run. If it is, I've succeeded.
Here at Heritage Park, though, I am admiring the scenery. This is a beautiful park out here. The sun is shining. It's a blue skies. It's a great day to do whatever we are doing.
That's right.
Battle run, I understand.
Well, let's stop asking about it and let's go get to it. Here we go. Dave Rosnowski, we are ready for the battle run.
And we're going to go through these woods all the way down, around. It's going to curve around and then we're going to take a right here.
Walk me through just briefly some of the obstacles. Heather, why don't you start?
Well, we're going to start by running through the woods, which is a beautiful scenic view. And as you come out of the woods, you'll come around and you'll hit your first obstacle, which is the rat maze. And that's going to be a lot of fun. You'll be crawling in and out of a maze, and then you'll come back out of that and go back out on the run, and you'll hit the other four obstacles, push-ups, sit-ups. We have a mulch pit, and then you'll come back around and do the tire pit, the tire run. So it'll be a challenge for everybody.
Okay, all right, we're here at this is the push-up station. These push-ups have to be done correctly. You got 1 minute to do as many as you can do properly, okay?
Can I keep my knees down?
You can, go ahead. If you need to, but you gotta do a minimum of 25.
I should have known better, and Jennifer signed me up for this.
Set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 22. 23, 24, 25, 26, he's an animal, 27, 1, 42, 43, 44, 45,
time,
good job.
Wow, very good.
Man. He's an animal, man.
More from Jennifer and Zach in just a moment, but first, a very special auction update.
We're sure you remember the cow, the cow that was a part of our recent auction. We featured the cow on our auction show, even included it with the auction game show hosted by Ben Reif. It was famous and it's becoming even more so.
Well, that cow is now living a wonderful life in picturesque Rockford, Ohio, at the home of Brandit Marketing Communications. And in fact, it's built quite a Facebook presence.
It has. Every day since the auction, there's been a new picture of the cow. And even though Matt Finkel and I named it during our auction game show, we realized that when the cow is adopted in a new home, well, the new owners get to pick a new name. That poor cow has an identity issue.
So Brandit Marketing is solicited ideas from the public for a new name for this special animal. The finalists were Bess, Brandson, Moonshine, Sweet, Cowerline, Moo Lisa, Maud, Buttercup Brandy, and Calvin.
Calvin and Hobbes? Well, they get a second cow?
That would, well, maybe Hobbes could be a piglet that would come over along.
There we go. We need a piglet for next year's
or
auction.
Or keeping with tradition of the actual cartoon, a stuffed tiger.
After a few days of voting, there was a tie. Sweet Caroline and Calvin. And so we're still waiting the winning name.
Yeah, thanks,
waiting.
Thanks to Twyla Hayes and all the great people at Brandit Marketing for taking such good care of the special cow. Now, no cows at the battle, but plenty of cadence calls. Let's send it back to Heritage Park as Zach and Jennifer continue the battle run.
When my grandma was 92.
When my grandma was 92.
She did PT better than you.
She did PT better than you.
I said, here we go.
Here we go.
On the move.
On the move.
In the groove.
In the groove.
Ah, we're down here. This is called Ambush Alley. And what that means is there's people from the National Guard and Kenton ROTC program going to be out here, and you could get wet or something through this area, okay? So that's going to be right through there. This is not a level grade, so there's hills, okay? So we'll show you that. There's a couple areas in here, what we call danger areas or danger zones.
Dave, why don't you tell me a little bit about the spiritual aspect that's going to be on this course?
Yeah, there's a couple of different areas. We have a encouragement bench where runners are going by. There's going to be people like, you know, cheering them on and saying, hey, you can make this, you know, and you can endure through this. And then we have also what we call a prayer corridor, where we're going to have like the flags of the missionaries there, where we can actually pray for those missionaries and let them know, you know, just in a way, just letting them know that we support them, you know, they're not there on the battlefield by themselves. And then the last part of the of the race, we're actually going to have a gospel presentation. You know, we're not, you know, blind to the idea that there's going to be people here that don't know the Lord. And so we really want to try to present the gospel to people that maybe may not know him.
One more check-in with those battle warriors in a few moments, but want to tell you about a great event that's coming up this week. Scott Young of WTGN joins us now. And Scott, you've got Charlie Dyer coming in from the Moody Bible Institute. He's going to tape his weekly show at the Shawnee Alliance Church coming up on September 27th.
That's right. The program's on WTGN Sunday nights, 6:05. And also right now we're broadcasting on Thursday nights at 7:05. But he's going to come to Shawnee Alliance, tape the program, take us through a lot of fun stuff. I mean, I guess if there's one message I'd like to get to people is this is not a two-hour lecture on what's taking place in Israel. You don't have to bring your notebook and write things down for two solid hours, and he's not going to take you through every Bible passage in the Old and New Testament. It's going to be a lot of interaction, a lot of fun. It should be a really great morning.
Yeah, I mean, for those who aren't familiar with this program, The Land and the Book, one of the things he does is he really brings the ancient lands and brings those into focus on what's going on in the current events in the Middle East.
Yeah, he'll deal a lot with that. And I know he's going to try to take us there right now with what's going on with ISIS and all the different things in the background of all that. But also, he's going to share a lot from his own experience. This guy has been to Israel like 80, 85 times. It's like his favorite place in the world, other than Lima, Ohio, of course. But, you know, he goes over there, and even as a Bible teacher, he used to be at Dallas Theological Seminary, he said the first time that he went, it was actually a part of his job, and he just couldn't wait to get back. It just impacted him. He said Bible passages that he had read for years, they just suddenly came to light because he was walking on the same ground where Jesus was and doing like some of the same things. So it's going to be a fun day.
Certainly from a biblical perspective, there's a lot to be concerned about, a lot to be interested in what's going on in the Middle East. It's been such a hot button topic for, you know, we like to say for the last couple of months, but really for the last couple of centuries.
Yes.
There's been so much going on in the Middle East, and it really takes a biblical perspective to kind of try and put it all into context.
You know, that's one of the reasons why we brought Charlie or bringing Charlie out for this event, because even like a guy like me, I mean, I love Israel. I know it's God's chosen people, that land is, and I know, but for me even, as a guy that loves the place, I don't think I love it maybe enough. And I think if I go to something like this, it'll give me even more of a heart for Jerusalem and for Israel. Psalm 122:6 says, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May those prosper, be secure, who love that city and pray for it. And so I want to get a better handle on it, be even more concerned, more aware of what's going on. So that's one of the reasons why Charlie Dyer's come.
Do you think maybe the modern American Christian doesn't really understand the importance of Jerusalem, of Israel?
Probably. I think there are many challenges in America. With so much information that's available to us, we're selective on what we look for. And I mean, when you have like a movie star that has so many hits or whatever on whatever page and something like that, and then you have other things, and people seem that they know more about movie stars than maybe what they do about the Holy Land. And I think there's something wrong with that.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's one of the things Charlie's trying to do throughout his program, is to really to educate as well as to entertain.
Yeah, oh yeah. It's going to be a lot of fun that day. But like you said earlier, the neat thing is we'll be able to hear this program on WTGN a little bit later on. So, hey, come up with a good question so you can get on the radio. You know, I always wanted to be on the radio.
It's going to be September 27th at Shawnee Alliance Church. There are tickets available. How can folks get tickets? They're $5 a piece?
We made it very affordable. We don't want the money to be the reason why you're not there. They're available at the church at Shawnee Alliance, but also at WTGN. Looks like they're going to be available the morning of the event. The event runs from 10 o'clock in the morning till noon. Doors open at 9. But we'd love for people to get their tickets ahead of time, get locked in, get committed to it, and show up. And plus, it helps them to prepare maybe with materials and some other things that they're going to be bringing.
And you were saying this might be maybe a perfect gift for maybe a pastor at your church.
Yeah, I think that would be great. I'd love to see every pastor in the area, or just about everyone. I realize some of them have other commitments that day. It's impossible for them to be there, but I'd love to see them there September 27th.
That is September 27th at Shawnee Alliance Church. Charlie Dyer's program, The Land and the Book, will be taped live at Shawnee Alliance Church and will be broadcast later on at WTGN Radio. Now, if you still need to be convinced to come out to the event, let's hear from Charlie himself on what you can expect.
We're going to take you to Caesarea, built by Herod the Great, and then I'm going to take you to Jerusalem. A walk down the Mount of Olives, a walk through the Via Dolorosa, a walk through the Jewish Quarter, from Hezekiah's Broad Wall to the Western Wall, and from ancient to modern, what are some of the conflicts there, and going down through the City of David excavations, and then in Bethlehem. Bethlehem, the Herodium, the birthplace of Christ, but also with Herod the Great and his burial place now. What's the interplay going on at the time of Christ's birth?
All right, why don't you just tell me the whole purpose behind doing this battle run?
Well, it's just to make the community aware of missions that are out there going on right now in places like the Philippines, Haiti, Rwanda, Lebanon. And we just want to make people aware that there's a need out there for the gospel to go forward. And this is a great way we can try to raise some funds to help those missionaries.
All right, then just give me the date, the time, how to register, and the cost.
It's October 4th, and it starts at 7:30 registration here at Heritage Park. And the first heat is at 8:30. And you can go to our website, battlerun.org, and all the information is on there.
All right, sounds great.
Thank you. We've got Father Mark Hodges here from St. Stephen's here in Lima on Shawnee Road, and they have a huge event coming up, a conference, the Ancient African Christianity Conference, Bridging Culture and Finding Common Ground. It'll be October 3rd, 4th, and 5th. The culture, the history of our church is just so important, so precious, and you guys are going to dig into that.
It's really foundational. It's relevant for all Christians to understand. You know, the old saying, if you don't know your history, you're doomed to repeat it. This is true for Christian history, too. The African church was one of the most vibrant, alive, largest branches of Christianity in existence until Muhammad and his armies and Muhammad's successors and Islam came and wiped it out. At one point in time when they went through the Middle East, it is said in Jerusalem the blood was 3 feet thick,
wow.
3 feet high in some places. But until Islam came through there, the African church was a leading church in worldwide Christendom. And we need to learn from these, our spiritual forebearers.
Right.
So the Brotherhood of St. Moses the Black is a African-American organization of Orthodox clergy and leaders throughout the United States. Every year they put on a conference on ancient African Christianity. They explore different aspects of it. They give teachings, discussions, workshops, and they interestingly tie it in to the suffering of black Americans during pre-Civil War and post-Civil War, through slavery and racism and so forth. And the spirituality that developed through that suffering is very akin to the spirituality of the African martyrs and the African Christians out of the African church. So it's an amazing, relevant, there are many aspects of Christianity that we just take for granted.
Yeah.
Dates of Easter, dates of Christmas, worship of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, our understanding of who Jesus is. These were forged in the early centuries of Christianity. These came out to be understood better and explained better to a world that challenged Christianity from outside and from inside. The African Christians were leaders in this and facing this challenge, and there's a lot to learn from them.
Sounds like it's going to be a great weekend. There is a cost of $100, but if you can't afford that, we don't want to make that a barrier.
Absolutely
anyone
not.
Is invited to it.
That's right. Anyone can be sponsored. Anyone can show up. We welcome everyone to come. It's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, October 3rd, 4th, and 5th.
Well, thank you very much. Sounds like it's going to be a really relevant weekend to our lives, and we can really look back so that we can move ahead forward in our Christian walks.
That's right. It's important for us even now. Culturally, we're divided in many ways.
Right.
And I don't have to recite for you the headlines in the newspaper to share that there are racial divides in our country.
Right.
And we're trying to bridge that through greater understanding. And it's, so it's not only relevant for all Christians, it's relevant for anyone concerned about different culture groups that are here in America, the melting pot.
That's a great point. You want to check that out? It will be at St. Stephen's, and that is October 3rd, 4th, and 5th. Thanks to Father Mark for joining us. And we have more as we roll along on Faith and Friends. Mark.
Thanks, Andy. Well, each Friday night all around our area, towns congregate at the local high school football stadium to cheer on their team. But what happens when the final buzzer sounds to end the game? Well, many churches from Ridgeway to Lima and beyond host a fifth quarter, opening their doors to students for games, food, door prizes, and a short devotional. Lima First Assembly of God Church recently hosted an event to give students a safe place to go have fun on a Friday night. Students from Allen East, Bath, Lima Senior, Perry, and Bluffton have attended the first two fifth quarters there. Shawnee Alliance Church and Shawnee Community have similar outreaches for the Shawnee Junior and Senior High students. Next, we welcome in Zach, who is freshly back from the Battle Run.
Well, thank you, Mark. This week, Bill Harris completes his four-week series based on 1 Chronicles 16. The last part of that verse talks about continually staying in the presence of God in order to sustain us in our day-to-day walk. Bill Harris entitles this Staying Connected to God and explains the importance of doing this and how to go about it. Bill, we're in the middle of your teaching series that's breaking down 1 Chronicles 16, verse 11, which talks about multiple things. It says, seek the Lord in his strength, yearn for and seek his face, and to be in his presence continually.
Yes.
And we've broken down last week one of the areas, which was the seek his face, the face-to-face relationship. You covered the other first two previously, so now we're to the final one, which is being in his presence continually, and you title that Staying Connected to God.
Yeah, I think that is so important, and when we look at it at first blush, Zach, and we think in our finite minds that, well, how do you stay connected to God? I mean, I can't stay on my knees 24/7. I've got work to do.
Right.
And that is so true. And do you know God understands that? He knows the world that we are living in. He knows the limitations we have. But with our spirit, that part that connects first with God, we can stay connected to him. And that spirit can lead us into either praise or worship, and the difference between those two, praise is when we're thanking God for what he has done for us. Worship is when we are honoring him for who he is. Those two things are very important. A third one is to indulge in the word of God.
Yeah.
And reading the word of God and confessing the word out loud, and prayer, just out and out prayer, praying and talking to the Lord. When we pray, we're ushered into the throne room for an immediate audience with the creator of the universe. I mean, that's some kind of connection right there.
Yes, it is.
We know people in high places.
That's true. So you outline four areas that we can stay connected, and you use a visual in your teaching to describe why we need to stay connected. And it starts with the fall with Adam and Adam and Eve in the separation from God. But the ultimate goal, as I understand it, is to align our spirit with His spirit.
That's true. I mean, when we do this, it's almost like a GPS system on Star and the like, because when we get off track, you know, you'll hear that voice, recalculating. They're trying to get you back on the course to your destination. This is what God is trying to do, to get us back to being reconnected to Him. It is not His will that any man should perish. That's what His word says. He makes it so plain, as the Bible says, that a fool need not err, so that we can be connected to Him.
That's right. And so once we are, that's where we can really experience the presence of God, the guidance, some of the discernment, the wisdom that He provides. And He's also going to bless us if we are in alignment with Him.
It's just like a regular investment. When you put in an investment in, you're taking a bit of risk. You're taking some of your resources to invest, and you're hoping for a return. Mm-hmm. We must invest our time. You wake up every morning with 86,400 seconds in a day.
Wow.
You know, that's the blank check that God gives you every day. You have to determine how you're going to write those checks out for the amount of time that you're going to spend here and there and with the Lord. And when we make those decisions right and we invest some of that time with Him, it pays off with great dividends like any other investment.
So when you're talking about praise and you're talking about worship and a couple of these things that we can do, specifically those two, you talk about how one is really a natural progression of the other.
Praise, when we're praising God for the things He has done, it's a natural, worship becomes a natural progression of that as we're now enveloped in awe of who He is. And the progression from that goes to being in His glory and being in His presence. That can happen right in our seats. And it doesn't, I'm not talking about some mystical, spooky type situation, but we begin to feel and sense in our spirits this easiness and this sense of peace, and that, yeah, there are those problems there, but you know what? I can sense God on board with me. He's got my back, and He's going to lead me through this. Some things God takes us around, some things He delivers us from, but there are a lot of things He takes us through. And when we go through them, we come out on the other side with a testimony, surely it was the hand of the Lord that brought me out.
Right. There's a confidence that is just really non-negotiable there, that you just come out of it feeling on fire. And when you look at praise and worship, you mentioned that worship is worshiping God for who He is. And I think that that is an important factor to consider, because sometimes emotionally we're not feeling so maybe great, or maybe we're in the middle of a tough situation and it doesn't seem like we can see anything positive going on. But that doesn't change the character of God. And I think that's important to remember.
It is. I can think about, take a person that's an avid sports fan, and they get caught up into somebody's record. You know, they just broke the record. And we get into awe of that, and we're so full of applause and the like. Well, that can take our mind off of problems and circumstances. But what about when we're dealing with the Lord? I mean, the Lord has, Jesus hit a home run, the ball's still going. Jesus made a touchdown, and that record is still standing. And we can keep going with that and be encouraged to know that He's more than enough. He's all that we need, you know?
As always, you can hear more on this topic this next week on Update with Bill Harris, Thursdays at 9 a.m. and Sundays at 1:30, right here on TV 44.
Thank you, Zach. Just a quick reminder that all of you can stay in touch with all of us. Prayer requests can be sent through email at prayer@wtlw.com or call 419-339-3000. Some other ways to stay in touch: through Twitter, Andy Lynch 44, Jen Beck 44, Matt Finkel 44, Bauer Z or Mark Hughes 44. Also, you can connect with Andy and Jennifer through Facebook.
Speaking of Jennifer, she is back from the run. You and Zach didn't die.
We survived.
Went through the straw mazes, okay, the rat mazes.
Well, they didn't have those set up for us, but we heard about them, and I think they're going to be pretty incredible.
Pretty challenging.
Well, the course itself is, have you been to Heritage Park? It's beautiful there. If you're running through there, all of the landscape, the trees, so that in itself was great, but then you do have the obstacles, the tires you've seen there. There's going to be some mulch crawling. There's going to be, I think, some secret surprise. I don't want to give it all away.
Do they have prizes hidden in the mulch?
I don't want to give it all away, but there may be something to find there. But yeah, bottom line is it's going to be a lot of fun and a great day.
I love the way that Dave and Heather Rosnowski have infiltrated the gospel in throughout that entire run. So they really want to use it as a way to raise money for missions, but also they're hoping that some of the people who, you know, maybe sign up just for, because it's a run, will, in the end, hear the message of Jesus Christ throughout that as well.
That's great. Quick reminder now of those two events we covered for you earlier in the show, The Land and the Book with Charlie Dyer, coming up this Saturday, September 27th, 10 a.m. and 12 noon at Shawnee Alliance Church. Tickets just $5, available at WTGN here in Lima or by calling 419-227-2525.
And then the next coming weekend, October 3rd, 4th, and 5th, is the Ancient Christianity Conference with Moses the Black and others. The time to register for that conference is now, and it will take place at St. Stephen Orthodox Church in Lima. Find out more by going to calling 419-224-8600.
As we near the end of our show, let's take a moment to pray over some of the prayer requests that we have received this past week from many of you. A viewer in Lima says, please pray for healing from the top of my head to the soles of my feet.
An area pastor recently wrote with a prayer request about his church, and he's also looking for people to have a hunger for the Lord. And a few weeks ago, a couple walked in and we learned that the husband has stage 4 cancer, just a few of the many requests. Andy, can you just take a moment and pray?
Definitely. Father, we hurt in this world. This world is not our home, and so we hurt. Disease and sadness and loss is all around us. We take comfort in the passage that Jesus himself wept and cried with us. And so we weep with these people that are hurting, and we pray for your healing, your deliverance, and your peace. We thank you that you are still the King of the universe. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Well, remember, you are welcome to share your prayer request with us by emailing prayer@wtlw.com, or you can call our prayer line at 419-339-4444. And finally, let's look at today's scripture once more. 2 Chronicles 20:14-15, which says, then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehazel and the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jael, the son of Mattaniah, a Levite from the sons of Asaph, in the midst of the assembly. And he said, listen, all of you of Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem, and you, King Jehoshaphat. Thus says the Lord to you, do not be afraid nor dismayed because of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's.
Don't forget, the battles belong to the Lord. Stand with him and follow his lead, and we'll be praying for you this week. Goodbye.